Good afternoon and welcome to this teleconferencing session of BSc Honours in Optometry program. And this is, let me tell you friends, this is the induction program for this particular BSc Honours in Optometry and Ophthalmic Techniques program. I welcome all the regional directors at all the regional centers, our program in charges sitting at the various regional centers, and the students of this particular programs who are sitting at various regional centers and or other study centers. I welcome you all to this particular program. So I think after a long wait of 2.5 years, this program has come into existence. And I still remember that when this program was conceived, Professor L.P. Agarwal, who was the key person who thought that this particular skills in optometry and ophthalmic technique should reach to the grassroots level of the community through this BSc Honours in Optometry and Ophthalmic Techniques program. So I think his dream has come true, and today we'll be having this introductory session, and we have with us Dr. T.K. Jaina. He is my colleague in School of Health Sciences, and also we have got Dr. Naveen Patnaik, who is the Secretary of the FOREC. So friends, without wasting any time, because we have got very limited time, what we'll be doing that we'll be giving a small presentation of what is IGNU and how the programs are being run in IGNU. Then we'll be giving some small presentation about the BSc Honours in Optometry program, and then we'll devote half an hour or so for your personal queries. Because I know, because this program has been little bit delayed, and you must be having very so many queries, so many apprehensions, so many doubts, and all those things we'll be trying to sort out in during this 1.5 hour sessions. So without wasting any time, I request Professor Jaina to tell our listeners, our students, to something about that, what is IGNU and how IGNU is giving various technical medical programs through distance education. Dr. Jaina.
Thank you, Dr. Arora. As you know, IGNU is a university. So like any other university, it is the head of the institution is vice chancellor, and who is linked with the pro vice chancellors, and then there are schools and divisions. We have 20 schools as on today, and there are about 10 divisions. These divisions help us to launch the programs. They provide the student support services. They provide all types of student linked things like evaluation, material distribution division. We have the finance linked things, computer, all those things are there. Then we have regional centers. Today there are nearly 65 regional centers, out of which at least there is one regional center in every state. And these regional centers, they control all the study centers. Like you are admitted to one of the study centers, so your institution will be controlled by the respective regional center of the state, which in turn will be linked to the regional center RSD or Regional Services Division at the headquarters, and also School of Health Science, and then ultimately the Vice Chancellor control seat. Next, please. You see, IGNU is the largest university in the world, and it is present in 35 countries. It is also involved in capacity building in many nations like Southeast Asia, Central Asia, Africa, Caribbean, China, and SAR countries. It also, if you see the, this is just a figures in glance, that programs, there are nearly 130 programs are on offer, and it involves nearly 1100 courses. These are only rounded figures. The exact figure will vary to some extent. Around 1.5 million students are there, and as I have already told, out of 65 regional centers, 7 are sub-centers and 58 are regional centers. There are 1300 study centers. And we have a radio counseling facility. Around 40 FM radio stations are there. And we have also, like you are seeing the teleconferencing, So receiving antenna, nearly 800 receiving antenna are there, and two-way interaction can be possible through EduSat, which is having 130 centers. This is what you are interacting right now. We are in the studio. This is the teleconferencing. Through satellite, we are linked to the TV and you are able to see us. Next. The program package, it is a multimedia package, we tell. Multiple media are involved. Like there is audio video, there is broadcast facility. You can see some programs in the morning in the TV. We have also radio counseling, so we can interact through FM radio stations. Teleconference right now, this process is teleconference is going on. We can also telecast the video programs and self-instruction material which is provided, the study material that you have already received. I think some of you might not have received due to postal delay, but some have also received it. And there is face-to-face interaction which will take place at your program study centers. In addition, we will also provide you some audio video. So this is whole package. Now, you see, as for the principles of distance education, you are enrolled now as student of distance education. What it means that you will have the freedom to start your study, to pace your study and stop your study. That means you can learn in your own pace. If you are enrolled for 4 years, you can complete the program in 4 years, or if you are a slow learner, you can even take few more years and that will be also accommodated. Learning activity is more important than teaching effort. Whatever the teachers will teach, more than that is the learning activity. What you are doing, your activity, your learning activity is more important. Therefore, we want you to put effort. Don't think that there will be just like conventional system classes will be there. There is no spoon feeding here. You will have to learn actively. Media can help to decrease the distance, and individual differences are being taken care, and evaluation is independent of your learning process. Next. What IGNU is doing, this implementation process, IGNU as a distance education is imparting the training through the program study center. Whatever center you are attached to, like for example St. Stephen's Hospital or some eye hospital in South, all these are basically program study centers. They will be linked to either we call it skill development center or work center. Work center are not being activated this year. In future, the students will be also linked to the work center. Next. So in brief, you will be provided study material, you will be attached to some institution, and this will take place through your demonstration and discussion will be there in your PSC. Then there will be some practical activity under supervision, and there you will be allowed to practice some of the activity. Next. You must know that in IGNU, whatever learning package, it is in terms of credit. When we tell it is 1 credit, it means 30 learning hours. It means you have to spend 30 hours to cover 1 credit of study material. When it is a 12 credit, we call it a certificate, but for your purpose, the last line, that is degree program, because yours is a degree program, so it will be 3 to 4 years. Yours is honors, BSc honors, so it is 4 years. In IGNU parlance, all the degree programs will be otherwise 3 years. If you see the terminology, whatever BSc honors, that is a program under which there are 5 courses, and each course will have some booklets, that is called block. So you will receive, in your situation, we have combined all the blocks together to make one manual or one booklet for each course. So you will be receiving 5 courses. Dr. Arora will show it later on. So there are 5 blocks. Next. And when you open your study material, you will find the chapters are written in this style. There is a structure, there will be objective, some introduction, and there will be some sections. So what is important, you should go through the objective of that lesson, and you should also go through all the sections. And there will be some small exercises. At the end, you will be required to check your progress. at the end that answers are given. So answer to check your progress is there at the end. So you do your exercises while reading, and at the end you can get the answer also. Next. So these are few programs which IGNU is already having in other fields. I'll just quickly go through. So in future, just this is for your information only, because we have few programs after MBBS, few programs after 10 plus 2, and few programs for nursing also. Like we have post basic BSc nursing program, we have PG diploma in maternal child health, PG diploma in hospital and health management, PG diploma in geriatric medicine, we have PG certificate in rural surgery, certificate in health and environment, and also we have like certificate in healthcare waste management, certificate in competency enhancement, and also we have PG diploma in community cardiology, diploma in nursing administration, and your program, that is BSc honors in optometry and ophthalmic techniques. So I think this is in nutshell I wanted to tell you. And regarding the BSc honors in optometry and ophthalmic techniques, Dr. Arora will tell you more in detail. We can answer your queries, whatever is there. Dr. Arora.
So friends, Dr. Jaina in very precisely told you that how the IGNU structure is there, and he told you that IGNU is a university set up by the Act of Parliament, and all its courses are recognized by UGC. So even this course, some people have that apprehension whether this there is a recognition of this particular course or not. This particular program, that is BSc Honours in Optometry and Ophthalmic Techniques, is very much recognized by UGC. So you need not to bother about the recognition. Then Dr. Jaina has told you about that about the networking of the IGNU, that we have got a big network of our regional centers and sub-regional centers spread throughout the country. Not only in the country, we have got our presence in the 35 countries, and he mentioned about all, gave you about that details. And then he has subsequently told you about that what is a credit. You see, in our system, when we are talking about that IGNU programs, we call it as a everything is determined in the terms of credit. And he told you that each credit is 30 hours. When we say 30 hours, then if you are going through your course, say there is a course in communicative English, if you are spending 30 hours, that will include reading the material, tutorial by the teachers, then answering your assignments, then teleconferencing, video conferencing, then interactive radio counseling, then audio-video programs. All these combined together will constitute 30 hours. So this, as we, let me tell you one more thing, that in each year, we have having 32 credit hours. So, more than 32 we can't include in a particular year. So the year, so first year will be 32 credits, and if we multiply 30 by 32, it will be 960 hours. So in all, whatever you have to put in the first year is 960 hours. This will include your theory, this will include your practical session, this will include your duties in the hospital, and various other exercises, and like this teleconferencing activities. So you just be prepared for that thing. We are telling this time and again, because you have to get prepared for that thing. In a year, you have to spend at least 1,000 hours. So if we say, if we think that, if we calculate that way, if there are 200 days in working days in a year, so approximately 5 to 6 hours you have to work in a day. So out of that, there will be some theory portion, and maybe you have to be posted in some wards or some clinics, or maybe some other departments of the that particular organization. So for this particular program, as Dr. Jaina was telling you, that we are launching this program through program study centers, and then we have got work centers also. Since the number of students in this particular program was limited, we had only around say 170-180 students. So we thought this year we will be having only program study centers. Program study center will be either a medical college or a optometry college, or it can be a big eye care hospital. So all these will be program study centers, and then there will be work centers. Since the number of students is very less, so this year we have not been able to activate the work centers. From next year onwards, we'll be activating work centers also. So what you can do, that 30 students who are present in the program study center, they can complete some activity, they can be demonstrated there. Then 5 or 6 or 4 students can go to each work center and they can work over there. So that is the basic concept of, and there will be certain things which you can do of your own also. You see, as Dr. Jaina told you, that you can pace your studies on your own. Before going further, I will request all the regional directors that wherever this program is being offered, if you can just fix that how many students are present and how many faculty members from each institution are present, if that can be fixed, or if you can communicate to us through telephone, I think that will be good. That will give us an idea that how we should further tailor this program. And now we have got Dr. Pankaj Vashne also with us, to my extreme right. He has been involved in development of this particular program. And let me tell you that the course material which you will be receiving, he has also contributed there. And now he will be telling you what is the role and responsibilities of the optometrist, and what are the various program study center which has been activated, and we'll be showing you the list of the students also, so that you can have an idea, and if there is any question you can ask in between also. Dr. Pankaj. You can tell what is the role and responsibilities of an optometrist.
An optometrist has to work, can work independently and also as an assistant to an eye surgeon. Independently, he can work as an optician, making out its own glasses, dispensing it, checking the number of the patients, and doing all the types of the things which can be beneficial to the public. Role and responsibilities of the optometrist: the candidate will play a vital role in providing eye care to patients and preventing blindness and vision threatening diseases by prescription of glasses, by pre and post operative eye care, organizing free eye camps helping in that, early estimation of an eye disease, school eye screening program, educating program for teachers and healthcare workers. Also, primary care in ocular diseases, testing of visual acuity and color vision, tonometry, retinoscopy, removal of foreign bodies, syringing, etc., and examination of refractive errors.
Sir, there is a call from Delhi 2.
Yes, Delhi 2, please come up. Yes, Delhi 2. Yes, Delhi 2. I think, hello,
disconnected,
okay, please keep on trying, we'll get take your question subsequently. Dr. Patnaik, Dr. Pankaj has just told the role of the optometrist. Would you like to add something else to this?
No, he has very rightly told about the role of the optometrists, but they are also very much helpful in the operation theater, assisting all operative. That's why you put the...
Yes, Delhi 2, please come up. Yes.
This is Sanjeev Pandey calling from Delhi 2.
Yes, Dr. Pandey.
First of all, my congratulations to you all for launching this very ambitious program. And of course, which is much sought after. We have about 20 students here who are participating, and of course, as and when any query is raised, we'll definitely inform you about it. Thank you, and over.
Thank you, Dr. Pandey. I think there are 20 students, and one student is sitting here. So, yes, Darbanga, please come up.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Pandey. We have two faculty members here. Dr. Vajesh Mali Kuram, sir.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Hello.
Yes, please.
As you have already
Yes, please. Go ahead.
As you have already said, the study hours will be 960 hours per year.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, yes. Go ahead, please.
How much will the study hour, the practical hour, and the study hour?
That we are going to tell you in future, because this is...
First year, second year, third year, we'll
be telling all you in 1.5 hours. That we will be covering that. Okay. So, we were talking about the roles of optometrists. You were telling something.
Sir, I was telling that the role of the optometry, not only in the screening program or in the day-to-day clinical work, they are also very much the ophthalmic technique. They should know how to fix the vitrectomy or phaco machine, and they are how to lay down the table in the operation theater. So that's why you put the optometric ophthalmic technique title. So they not only they will be.
I think we will not go into that controversy.
This is one of the roles of this thing.
Yeah. So we will not go into the nomenclature of this particular program at the moment, okay, because there are. Dr. Pankaj, would you tell our students that what are the various program study centers which has been activated?
List given in this.
List slide, may I say.
The various program study centers which have been activated at present are: number one, Sadguru Seva Center in Madhya Pradesh, then Sahai Hospital at Jaipur, then Khairabad Eye Hospital at Kanpur, Malabar Eye Hospital at Calicut, Netrajyoti Mandiram at Patna, Muzaffarpur Eye Hospital, Darbhanga, St. Stephen Hospital, Tees Hazari, Delhi, Dr. Shroff Charity Eye Hospital, Daryaganj, Delhi, Eye Care Eye Hospital, Noida, Drishti Netrale, Dahod, Gujarat, and Rajaram Memorial Eye Hospital Society, Banda, UP.
This is a list of students at Sadguru Eye Center.
This is a list of students.
This is the list of students for Sadguru Seva Sangh Trust, MP.
I think we have admitted 10 students. So this is the list of the 10 students who have been allotted Sadguru in MP.
Chitrakut.
That this is the list of students which have been admitted to Sahai Hospital and Research Center, Jaipur.
There are 9 students which have been admitted. One more students will be allotted to this particular center.
Then at Khairabad Eye Hospital, Kanpur, these are the students which have been given admission. At Malabar Eye Hospital, Calicut, these are the students, 7 students.
We have still scope of
1 student.
Taking more. 3 more students.
3 more students.
3 more students. The Netrajyoti Seva Mandiram, Patna, we have 10 students. Muzaffarpur Eye Hospital, Muzaffarpur, 10 students. Then at St. Stephen's Hospital, Delhi,
20.
These are the list of students. There are around 20 students. Dr. Shroff Charity Eye Hospital, this is the list of students which have been given admission. Eye Care Hospital, Noida, this is the list of students. Then Drishti Netrale, Dahod, this is the list of students which have been given admission. Sri Rajaram Memorial Eye Hospital Society, Banda, we have
9 students.
Yes, Guwahati, please come up. Yes, Guwahati. I think before we get connected to Guwahati, what I would like to say, mention that as Pankaj has told you that we are having 11 program study centers, 3 in Delhi and 8 in other states. And at each program study center we have admitted 10 students, except for St. Stephen, where we have admitted 20 students. And Let me tell you that that mission is still open because our Vice Chancellor has given his sanction, his approval, kind of approval he has given that because there was a lot of demand for this particular program, so now students were applying, so he has given the approval for extending this up to 31st of July. So the centers we can activate up to 31st July also. So the two more centers which we are in the process of opening, one is in Guwahati. That I think that question may be related to that. We are going to activate that center there also. They have already shortlisted 10 candidates, and they will be their admission will be finalized by the 31st of July. And similarly, we are trying to open a center in Chandigarh also, and we are also Yes, Jaipur, please come up.
Good afternoon, Dr. Arora and Dr. Naika.
Good.
This is Dr. Anshu Sahai from Jaipur. I'm speaking the economics here.
Good afternoon, Dr.
I have seven of the nine candidates allotted to us. Apart from that, we have five faculty members sitting here in the economics right now.
Thank you very much, sir.
We are sitting here in Jaipur, in the economics in Jaipur.
Okay, thank you very much. If you have any question, you can ask during our discussions, sir. Okay, so I think as I was telling you that we are going to open two more centers, one in Guwahati, one in this thing, and this still option is open if there are certain other centers in the country which fulfill our requirements, because there are certain laid down criteria by we have got an advisory committee meeting, and if there are certain centers who fulfill our criteria, we are willing to open more centers also, and we can enroll 10 students per center also. But at the moment, we are in the process of one opening in Guwahati and another opening in the Chandigarh. And now, Dr. Pankaj, since you have been... Yes, Bangalore? Yes, please? Yes, please? Okay, I think there is some problem in connection. You have been involved in the making of syllabus. So can you tell our students that I will be just showing that what is the syllabus of this whole particular 4 years program? Maybe you can just tell our students what is the. Dr. Jaina has told you that we are having a program. The name of the program is BSC Honours in Optometry and Ophthalmic Techniques. And we have got, in the first year, we have got six courses, five theory courses and one practical course. And I think Dr. Pankaj can give you an idea of that.
In first year, in theory courses, we have course one, which is communicative English, course two, computer skills, Course 3, Basic Human Sciences, which includes General Anatomy, Physiology, Biochemistry, Microbiology, Pathology, related to all body parts except eye. Then Course 4 is the Basic Ocular Sciences, which includes all these subspecialties pertaining to eye. Then Course 5 is Optometry Practice. In second year, we have four courses and a practical. Course 6 is Optics and Refraction. Course 7 is Diseases of the Eye. Course 8 is Squint and Orthoptics. Course 9 is Diagnostic Modalities in Ophthalmology.
I think we can show the students because this is very important component. I think we can show the slides and then can we have the slides, please? Can we have the slides, please? Yes, Bangalore.
Yes,
Mr. Dr. Ravinder,
I am speaking from Veteran International Institute of Ophthalmology.
Yes, Dr.
Ravinder. Dr. Arora, I have already spoken to you, and we have sent 8 DDs for enrollment. And how come our study center is not active?
I think the 8 students which we have sent it is for lateral entry. It is not for the admission to the first year.
All are ready for first year. Yeah, all are for first year. Since you are open lateral entry from January,
No, no. Lateral entry will be opening from the third year. When we reach the third year of the program, only then we'll be opening the lateral entry. Since all your forms which we have sent, they were for lateral entry, that's why the center is very much activated there. But we have not allotted the students because the... Yes, please, yes, doctor. No, no, because are they willing to take admission in first year? They are willing to take admission in first year? Okay, then we'll finalize that thing. In that case, what I will suggest you, that if you can find two more candidates, so we can make a full quota of 10 and we can allot 10 students in the first. Is that okay, sir?
Yeah, fine.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Ravindan, for this. So we'll proceed further. So can you just show us the slides, please? This PowerPoint? Yeah. So, yes, Dr. Pankaj, you can tell. This is the course 1 on communicative English.
In course 1 in communicative English, we have various blocks. Block 1 is reading comprehension, which includes various units like Animal Farm by George Orwell, Human Environment by Indira Gandhi, The Study of Genes, A World of Four Senses by Ved. Then there is Block 2 is for skills, writing skills. It also consists of I think 6 units, and this include writing paragraphs, the development of a paragraph, formal letters, part 2, writing reports, writing tables, making charts and graphs, and making clinical case study. In block 3, study skills, this will be improving your study skills by note taking, some basic devices for note taking, the use of tables and graphic organizers, then listening to the lecture, how to listen to it and note down the various summary points and writing the summaries. Block 4 is speaking skills, communication skills, why are they important? Formal conversation face to face, informal conversation face to face, telephone conversation, which is very important for the post of optometrist, interviews and case presentations. Then computer skills is included because computer is an essential part for our daily life, including medicine. And this will explain you Windows and professional and internet. This will teach you about number 1, introduction to computers, then Windows 2000 interface, Windows Explorer and applications, introduction to internet. Then in Microsoft Word, introduction to Microsoft Word, formatting document, desktop publishing features, advanced features in Word. Then in introduction to MS Excel and PowerPoint, how to use this Microsoft Excel and PowerPoint. Then the basic introduction to these two and utilization of these two for making slides and presentations. Then we come to the specialized part of computers, that is computers in ophthalmology. How computer is helpful in medicine, how it is helpful in hospitals and clinics, and how electronic patient record is made and maintained, and how to use internet in ophthalmology.
Yes, Guwahati, please come up. Yes, Pankaj, we have to take a call from Guwahati. Yes, Guwahati.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon.
I have a dean here, a program in class of Programme-1 at Santa Mitraya, Dr. Kastuni Bhattacharya, the regional consultant, Dr. P. K. Deka.
Good afternoon.
I'd like to ask some questions from the other.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. You just please. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Bhattacharya. what we were just, this is the program structure which we are trying to show you. And as I mentioned that Dr. Jaina also mentioned in the beginning that there is a flexibility and the pacing can be done. Now you see, we have allotted you 960 hours of the study. And there are certain theory classes, there will be certain practical classes. Now we will be having a meeting of all the program in charges toward the end of this month or first week of the August. There will be discussing various models that how these programs can be implemented. So as you are mentioning that if there is a particular institution though which has got lot of work, they want to take classes on weekend, they can take it provided they fulfill our requirements. There may be certain other institution who would like that, okay, students comes every day, they come for 3 to 4 hours. Now that will be depending upon the understanding between the students and the program in charge and the convenience, because the basic philosophy of IGNU is to utilize the infrastructure of the various program study center without interfering their functions. We don't want that whatever activities, whatever work you are carrying on, we should interfere with that. At the same time, we also want that our students should get a very quality training. If after the 4 years they come out of your institutions, they should be proud of that, saying that I have done my BSc optometry from Shankar Netralaya, where I got a very quality training. So that the next year when the admission is on, there is so much demand for that, people give an option for Shankar Netralaya or a particular. So that flexibility is there. But the program structure which we are telling you that this has got, in every year we have got 32 credit, and in the first year we have got, as I was telling you, that we have got 5 courses and 1 practical manual also. That we'll be talking about that thing. So that is, that flexibility is still there. So I think that answers your question, Dr. Bhattacharya. If there is still some doubt, you can please.
Sir, can I? Just. Is a full time course. That's what you want.
That is basically, this is a, if you see, the student has to take it as a full time. Along with this, they can't pursue any other course. Yes. In that term, it is a full time course.
All from Guwahati.
Yes, Guwahati, please come up. Yeah. No, you see the course. You see the course material we have dispatched on Friday or Saturday they have dispatched. I think within next week you will be receiving the course material. Right now what we have done, that we have sent these 4 blocks, and 4 courses plus 1 program guide we have sent. So this 5 books have been sent to the program study centers. You will be getting 12 sets, 10 sets for the students and 2 sets for the organization. So we have sent already this 12, and in next month, by the end of August, you will be getting the other 2 courses plus the assignments also. So by the end of August, you will be having all material. As I told you that we are going to have a meeting of the programming charges. In that, we will be finalizing some of the integrities of the practicals, that how to give the practical components, how to implement that thing. So that's why we are little bit delayed, that practical component that that is under printing, but we have just withhold that thing so that after that meeting we can finalize that.
There's a call from
Delhi. Yes, Delhi. Yes, Delhi, please come up.
Hello.
Please lower down your volume of the TV. ये मैं अभी आपको यही बता रहा था ना, कोर्स स्टार्ट तो हो चुका है, आज से कोर्स स्टार्ट हो चुका है फॉर्मली, ठीक है ना? अभी 1 अगस्त से जो है रेगुलर क्लासेस शुरू हो जाएंगे आपकी. वो क्लासेस कैसे होंगी, कैसे कैसे करेंगे, वो हर एक इंडिविजुअल इंस्टीट्यूशन के डिपेंड कर. आपका सेंट स्टीफन में हुआ है, तो आपके जो प्रोग्राम इंचार्ज है वो आपको बताएंगे आपको कैसे क्लासेस अरेंज करनी है, कब कब आना है ना. हर एक इंस्टीट्यूशन का अलग अलग टाइम टेबल होगा. यस, दरभंगा.
हेलो.
हाँ जी.
हेलो.
हाँ, यस प्लीज.
गुड आफ्टरनून.
गुड आफ्टरनून. Yes, please.
What will be the minimum qualification of the teacher?
I think that
communicating English. And communicating to the
students. Sir, this I think we need not to discuss this, otherwise we'll be having, we have got only 1.5 hours to discuss. These all things we will be discussing when we are having this our, we'll be having a meeting of PICs and the academic counselors towards the end of this month or first week of August. So I think these issues we will discuss over there. But otherwise, definitely a postgraduate teachers in English will be able to teach the English of this particular level. That is the basic qualification for teaching this. And the person who is well trained in the MCA or BCA, who is trained in computer, he will be able to teach these students in computers. So that, those are the basic things. I think we'll discuss all these things when we are having the meeting of the Academy Council Center. So, but we were talking about that the course BS003 was basic human sciences. Dr. Pankaj, just tell in brief, because we have got only 2-3 minutes. And then we'll have a break and then we'll start. Basic human sciences, yes.
Slide. PowerPoint, please. In basic human sciences, we have block 1, which includes anatomy.
And it has got
four units for various systems. In physiology, it has around 6 units for various systems. And then general pathology and general microbiology, which includes all bacteriology, virology, and pathology of human body, and pathology of other parts of the body, including eye. Then in pharmacology, we have basic concepts of pharmacology, drugs, drugs affecting the cardiovascular respiratory systems, anti-allergic drugs, chemotherapy, general and local anesthetics, and sedatives and hypnotics. In biochemistry, we have simple biochemistry, which is equivalent to first year of basic. Then basic ocular sciences is the fourth section of the book, which include ocular anatomy in block 1, then ocular physiology and biochemistry in block 2. In block 3 we have ocular pathology and microbiology. Block 4 we have ocular pharmacology. Then in fifth book we have optometric practice. In this first block is physical and geometrical optics. Second block is method of eye examination. Third block is community health. Fourth block is hospital equipment. Then we have practical manual, which includes practical tips for communicative English, computer skills, basic human sciences, basic ocular sciences, and optometry practice.
I think this is in nutshell. We have told you about what will be the syllabus like thing. Now we'll have a break for 15 minutes and whatever your questions are. And now after the break, I will be telling you in detail that what is this, what are the various programs, how to write assignments, how this program will be implemented. Meanwhile, what you can do that if you have got certain specific questions, you can fax during this break. So what we can do that we can save some time. When we come after 15 minutes, we can take those faxes to start with, and then we can go on to other programs. So we'll have a break. You also have enjoy your tea and then come back after 15 minutes.